Hey guys, it's History Behind the Warrior, and welcome to another episode of HB Talks. Now this is going to be a bit of a controversial one, as I hear it a lot in the community. And I want to kind of put my opinion out there, as I feel that everyone is entitled to their own opinion and has the right to say what they need to say about this discussion. Now ever since EVO 2016, I've been seeing a lot of people say that Mortal Kombat is officially dead. Now like most of the time in HB Talks, I'm going to be devil's advocate and say what's going on both sides. Now I want to talk about the very beginning when the game first came out. The game was marketed extremely well, and you can see by how many copies they in fact sold. Now on a competitive circuit, the game did extremely well in the first year, and I'd say this is vastly due to KP1, as with each DLC character came a different patch, which would nerf or buff certain characters that honestly did need it. So essentially, the game was in fact given the love that it really needed, and due to all of these patches not being too much, it didn't really destroy the competitive circuit of the game. But with the arrival of KP2, things began to fall flat, and this was vastly due to KP2 dropping all four characters at the same time, meaning that the game wasn't really updated too often, and this kind of put a strain on it. Now eventually KP2 did come out, and we did get about two patches, one for the DLC characters when they were released, and another one which pretty much destroyed every aspect of Cyrax alike. So what? Oh, let's go back to the video. So ever since this last patch, Alien has pretty much been dominating most of the competitive tournament, and due to the fact that Mortal Kombat hasn't been patched in an extremely long amount of time, people are just kind of getting stale of the meta. Now due to the game not really being patched too often, it's kind of spread into the competitive scene. Have some people have left due to them being upset or just really bored of how things are. And this is vastly due to Alien winning most tournaments. Now ever since EVO 2016, the community has died down a lot. And I guess this is due to people wanting to see some new stuff. And I guess this is also due to Ed Boon pretty much cock-teasing about like a KP3. So I think this is another reason why it's kind of hurt the game. Now due to there not being a patch in a long time, a lot of people have been saying this game is officially dead. To which I say bollocks. Has the meta of the game got stale? Yes it has. But it hasn't affected the game in such a way that it's essentially just completely driven everyone off the edge. And I think some people have been blowing it a little bit too much out of proportion. Now is a patch needed? Very much so. And when the next patch comes out, it is going to breathe a little bit of life back into this game. Now of course there's going to be some naysayers about it, but it will happen. But I want to be completely honest here, this is going to be the last patch for the game. So it's understandable that there's going to be some people who doubt this. So there's some people who believe that this game will not really continue on in the competitive scene, but I will argue and say that this game probably has one more EVO left in it. Now there are some people that argue and say that KP3 is going to happen, but I will tell you that the harsh reality is that it's not going to happen. At least that's what I believe, and this is mostly due to NRS putting all of their focus into Injustice 2 at the moment, so it's not like all of their concentration is on Mortal Kombat right now. So it explains why there's been a lack of patches and a lack of communication with people within the competitive circuit. Now every dog has its day, but eventually it's gonna die out. So to answer the question of Mortal Kombat being dead, it's really not that dead. This can be seen as like, there are still competitions for Mortal Kombat X right now. If a game is truly dead, then there will be no competitions. But I think a lot of the spark in the game will begin to diminish in Injustice 2, as a lot of professional players in Mortal Kombat are just NRS players, as in they only play games from that certain studio. And I've been wanting to talk about this for a very long time, as I've been hearing a lot of people kind of complain about it. I'm not going to entirely disagree with them, as I really do feel like the meta has become extremely stale, as a very large meta of the game seems to be 50-50s vortexing or just armoring through everything. But that's just kind of my opinion about it. But what do you guys think? Do you think it'll die out before the next EVO? You think Injustice will kill the game? Will the patch be any good? Will Ed Boon ever stop being a massive cock tease? Anyway guys, that's been this episode of HB Talks. I really wanted to talk about this. I hope you enjoyed a bit of the humor at the end. I'm trying to incorporate a bit more humor into my channel, but only on these videos. But I genuinely want to make more episodes of HB Talks, but I don't know which topics to talk about, so please put down in the comments below what you'd like to see me kind of have my own opinion of. So now as always guys, please comment, like, subscribe, and share this video with everyone you know. Please take care, and I will see you all next time.